Well, good morning, BC family. Let's try it again. Good morning, BC family. Happy Sabbath. It's afternoon, isn't it? Good afternoon, BC family. We're so glad to have you guys here with us worshiping today. We're going to sing a few songs. Is that all right this morning or afternoon? Yeah? All right. Well, we're going to sing. We're going to start off today's service singing a nice old hymn that we think you guys may enjoy. It's called Marching to Zion. Would you guys stand with us and sing? Sing, come we that love the Lord.
Come we that love the Lord, and let our joys be known. Join in a song with sweet accord. Join in a song with sweet accord. And thus around the throne, and thus around the throne. We're marching to Zion. Beautiful, beautiful Zion. We're marching upward to Zion, the beautiful city of God.
Oh, you guys sound beautiful this morning. We're going to sing the next verse. Let's sing with us. Let's go on the next one.
But those refuse to sing who never knew our
but children
love.
Of the heavenly King.
But children of the heavenly King. But children of the heavenly King.
They speak their joys abroad.
They speak their joys abroad.
To do is let our songs abound to the Lord. Let's sing about that. Let our songs abound.
And let our songs abound and every tear be dry.
We're marching through Emmanuel's ground.
We're marching through Emmanuel's ground. We're marching through Emmanuel's
ground. To fairer worlds.
To fairer worlds on high. To fairer.
Look forward to that day when we get to march up to Zion with our Savior. Amen. Well, we are going to be singing another song. And when we think about marching up to Zion, that's a beautiful thing, but it's in the future, right? So we still have today that we have to deal with. We have our lives here on this earth. And sometimes those lives can be a little bit difficult, a little bit tough. And it can be hard to focus on that future time of marching to Zion. Amen. In spite of that, what God tells us that he wants us to do, no matter how difficult the circumstance, no matter how tough the time that you're going through on this planet, what he wants us to do is raise a hallelujah to him, amen? And hallelujah means that we are going to always focus on the fact that he is in charge and we can trust that he is going to lead us wherever we need to go. So remember, we're going to raise a hallelujah together. We're going to sing about that.
I raise a hallelujah. Hallelujah.
As we raise a hallelujah, I'm gonna sing.
I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm.
Louder and loud.
Louder and louder. You're gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will arise.
Death is defeated.
Death is defeated. The King is alive.
Can we sing that again? I raise a hallelujah.
Heaven comes to fight for me.
We talked about this in the first service. There is, in the book of Revelation, John talks about a bunch of different things, but something in particular, he had a vision, and God showed him some creatures, some interesting looking creatures. He had a lion, he had an eagle, a couple others, and these creatures were all around the throne of God. But something distinctive about these creatures was not just how they looked, but what they did. These creatures, see, the only purpose that they had was to go and be around the throne of God and only to say, "Holy, holy, holy, the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." Now, how good of a God must that be for them to do just that? Isn't that amazing? So if they can do that, can't we do the same thing? You guys think we can do the same thing and just say, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty"? Amen? We're going to sing about that a little bit as well. And it goes like this. Let's build that up a little bit. Can we sing Alleluia again?
Holy,
you are holy,
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 Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love. And because of that love, he allowed them to hang him high. They stretched him wide. They hung his head. For me, he died. That's love. That's love. And my favorite part of this song, that's love, is the next part, because that's not how the story ends. But that's not how the story ends. Because in 3 days, guess what he did? He rose again.
That's love.
Yes. Let's think about that a little bit more. Is that okay? Because that's love, guys. That's love. That's love.
That's love. That's love.
That's love. That's the kind of love Christ has for us.
That's love. That's love.
That he would be willing to go to the ends of the cross.
That's love.
Just to show us how much he loves each and every one of us.
That's love.
I can't imagine a love like that.
That's love.